So, Katie, let's start with you first of all. So this was earlier this month and you attended a Settle folk gathering. So just explain what you saw there.
Yeah, so I was on a walking weekend with some friends and we stumbled across the folk gathering, which initially I was quite excited about because I don't often come into contact with English folk culture, so it's something I wanted to learn more about. But I then noticed that some of the dancing groups there had fully blacked up their faces, which is not something I've actually seen in England before. So I was initially very surprised, and the longer I stayed, the more uncomfortable I felt. As someone who has Afro-Caribbean heritage, blackface has very specific meaning for people of my community. Mm-hmm. So it was a very odd experience, and it made me feel that I couldn't fully participate in the event.
And you felt other people were looking at you at the same time, sort of trying to gauge your reaction to it.
I was one of the only people of colour in the crowd at that time, so I really felt like I stood out, and it was quite an uncomfortable experience.
Mm. Right. Your mum's Afro-Caribbean, your dad is British.
Yeah.
And so you were there watching this. Part of English heritage, John. This is what you do.
Why is that part of that?
Okay. Well, back in the 1400s, which is where it's the earliest recorded events are, in the winter time, the farm workers would disguise themselves to beg.
Right.
They couldn't get anything from the land. They had no other income apart from the wealth, the landowners that used to own the cottages. So during the winter, they would put rags on their jackets, maybe put bells on, disguise their faces, normally with soot from the chimney and some grease, and beg, go back home, take it all off. No one was any the wiser. And the next day they went back to work without any trouble.
Now, that is disputed because there are many different reasons for why you, the members of your, not necessarily your troop, but troops of Morris Dancers wear blackface. Do you understand that it does have upsetting racial connotations?
We don't think... Personally, we don't think it does. It predates any racial connotations. It has no connection with the things that are being associated with it at the moment in terms of minstrelsy and whatever else. It way predates all that stuff. And it is purely a form of disguise.
Well, I would dispute that. I did a bit of research on my own after I sort of had this experience. And there seems to be a good deal of historical evidence later on from the period you're talking about, which links American minstrel shows and crude stereotypes brought over from the US during the Jim Crow era to English folk tradition.
Well, the minstrel shows were white performers in blackface in America from the 1830s to the 1950s, and that was disparaging.
Yeah, definitely. And I also read there are actually... There's historical literature in the UK that confirms that an alternative name for Border Morris in the early 20th century was actually N-word dancing, wow. Which I think really shows the historic link there.
Also, I just wanted to... Because the Morris Federation, this is what they say. They say as much as blacking up is seen as a traditional form of disguise, in the culturally diverse society in which we live, we should consider its appropriateness. While disguise may be an integral part of many teams' performances, there are alternatives that can be just as effective, using a different form of disguise or changing the colour of their face paint. Would that not be an option? I mean, that's your federation saying that.
Yes, and you know, you've probably seen this stuff from the joint Morris Federations and HM government saying that it's not racist. So
right.
We've discussed this a lot. We have an AGM every year. It comes up and our take on this is it's integral to our ethos. It's what we do, how we look. And if it becomes a real problem in the world at large, we'll probably just stop. Mm. Changing for a different colour or taking it off altogether, as I am today, just doesn't seem to work. We don't black our faces and wear ordinary clothes. We're not going out to mock anybody or to, you know, be in any way racially abusive. What we do, it's a costume. We wear silly hats and when we dance, and we dance 30 times a year, at festivals, at fetes, at corporate events. And in 28 years, we've probably had 4 complaints.
It was banned in Shrewsbury in 2016, though.
No, it wasn't banned. One person complained and a pressure group took issue with the organisers.
So are they doing it still?
They're not booking blackface border Morris.
So it's been banned?
They don't want to get involved in legislation. Mm. But
having said that, aren't you being a bit of a snowflake here? I mean, aren't you being a bit overly offended?
Don't say that.
Yeah, I think it may be because I'm a young woman, you know, it can be quite easy to dismiss my experiences as being this snowflake millennial. But look, the way I think another way to look at offence is causing hurt to somebody who has done nothing to you. And whether or not you find it easy to dismiss my experiences, you must also consider that, you know, an elderly lady who's faced racism all the way through her life will also be feeling the same, as will a young child. So I think, you know, we really sort of have to think about the broader cultural context that blackface has attached to it. Regardless
of the and that's something
today.
That you should we should be taking. Obviously, you perform. People love to see you. They love watching you. It's great for families. It just doesn't look great for the kids now. Not in this climate. Not in 2019.
The kids that we always have audience participation. Kids of all ages and racial demographics join in. They have a ball.
Do you take offence when somebody comes to you and says you shouldn't be doing that because of the racial
connotation? No, because I think it just needs explaining. If anybody comes up to us and says, you know, you're being casually racist or what's the meaning of this, we've never had anybody go away that hasn't been satisfied with the answer. Mm. We're not doing our eyes and our lips and wearing gloves. We're not pretending to be anybody else or a different race. Wearing an outfit which we dance in, and it takes all kinds
of... So he's saying it's an explanation. Now you've heard the explanation. Mm. Do you feel any better about things?
I mean, I completely understand what you're saying, and I do sincerely believe that there is no racist intent in what your dance troupe are setting out to do.
Yeah.
However, I think it's really important to understand that blackface has this really long history of being used to mock and parody black people and to entrench negative racial stereotypes. And for people of colour who are still battling these same stereotypes today, encountering blackface, it's impossible to separate it from this longer history of dehumanisation. So it really is the broader context that surrounds the particular tradition.
Yeah.